2 Accent on TV. Best of Poland and Europe. Right here on LA Talk Radio.
Oh my gosh. Monday. Again, Monday.
Again.
I'm happy I'm here. I know Marek Bacik, my co-host.
I'm always
happy.
You
have a headache today.
I do. Because really, I think you give it to me.
No, I do not have a headache. But my head is a little spinning.
I know. After the radio show?
We had a really, really unusual radio show, and I'm very proud of our accent on the radio, which is at 6, 7 p.m.
That's
Pacific
right.
time. We had amazing guests. We have two of them still with us, and we'll be having
a
great time.
And I just
want
to thank you for finally bringing a woman to the studio. You're surrounding yourself by guys, good-looking guys.
No.
And I never saw. Yes, most of the time.
No.
Yes, you do. And
finally,
we got woman from Brazil, right?
Yes.
I remember.
We have Caroline, beautiful Polish
lady. But
there
was like,
we have Lucy.
But
here.
We have to share it once in a while.
It's got to
be some. But it's got to be some love going on. Yeah, you
always here.
And you're not wearing red today. What you should wear.
No, I just tried to go business because we were promoting exhibition in Sofitel Hotel on the 21st July. And we'll be watching, seeing. New painter on the market. This is our guest. Ralph was a bass player for Scorpion.
Right. Yeah, that's
big
a huge
rock band.
Yeah.
And anybody who wants to hear his interview, his life is really, really fascinating.
Yes.
Full of turns left and
right. I think she's still in shock to meeting him.
I think Ty.
I am. Okay. I was just sitting there like, what am I going to talk about?
I know. After listening to somebody's so colorful life, you say, my life sucks.
No,
you
it doesn't
right?
suck. It's pretty
doesn't
good.
Suck.
You can kind of look at it differently. I mean, he did different lives. You know what I mean? Life is not
that
bad.
That's true. I like your point of view.
You know?
Then Ralph.
Right.
Ralph has his exhibition. Everybody who wants to know a little bit about very known bass player from Scorpion, who right now turned into painter and DJ.
He's supposed to be a good painter.
He's a very good painter.
That's
please
right.
Check his
here.
Website. Yes, ralph.art.
No, it's ralphsart.com.
You remember everything.
I remember.
Do you remember his address where he lives?
Yeah. Could you say everything? Because
it's ralphsart.com. I know. I have.
He's very simple.
No,
you have good memory.
Sometimes I have a good memory.
That's okay. You told me your mom loves scorpions.
Yes.
So we got it.
Mama,
so what did you do on 4th of July? What did you do on 4th of July?
That was very unusual holiday for me. I never.
Really?
I didn't see really fireworks. I decided to just not celebrate this way.
But you were lucky because one of the guys put fireworks on his head.
Oh
and killed himself.
No, that wasn't me. God
no, yeah, I know. I was just like, how stupid can you be?
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
really?
He put a firework on his head, 32 years old man, and killed himself.
Is it on purpose?
Yeah.
No. No, he just
want to
show. No, he just want to show it off in front of his friends.
Oh my God!
Wow.
Yeah, I thought it was on purpose.
No,
okay.
It was just crazy.
If people don't know what they are watching right now,
yeah.
This is Accent on TV,
that's
the
right.
best of Poland and
Europe,
and I'm Ilona Europa, your host. This is Marek Bacik.
That's
thank
right.
you, Mareczku, for being here. We both are from Poland, and today we have very, very beautiful lady next to me. And
that's
you're right.
right.
Maybe we need to bring some hot ladies.
Right. Once
you just
once
look for
just
them.
Mix it up. I can't go on the corner. I'm going to look at pervert. Go, hey, you want to go to the
and
show?
You are married. We always say you are very happily married.
I know.
Like
I am. But know what I'm saying. I can't just go on the corner and go, hey, what's up?
Yeah,
you
want
to come to the
no,
studio?
No, you can.
You
anyway,
know?
I'll try to take care of it.
You got it.
Okay, but
you
for
it.
Today, look at what
I know. It's amazing. She's
what
gorgeous.
Is your name, you beautiful lady?
Hi, I'm Thais. I'm from Brazil, and I'm a singer-songwriter, and I'll be singing here today, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm
really?
So happy
talking.
To be here.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, and of course we know each
it's
other.
It's the second time I'm here, and I'm really, really happy to be back, because Ilona is just amazing. She makes me
Aww,
laugh so much.
I
she
know.
Is.
She
and
I love
beautifully.
Laughing, so.
Yeah, you
we
should,
have this good
should.
Energy. Look at the face. Look at the honest eyes. And yeah, she's from Brazil.
Yeah.
Last,
and I
like,
brought...
Yeah, you brought today
I
wonderful
brought my
friend.
Amazing friend, Raz Azrai, from Malaysia. And he's gonna be playing guitar.
Wow!
From Malaysia. Then
Malaysia.
Maybe
did
we
you
are
came
not
from Malaysia. You were born in Malaysia, or
I was born in Malaysia.
Oh, really? Wow, that's awesome.
No,
we'll
you're
be
born in
we'll be having lots of questions. We'll be asking them about everything from age of 5 or 6 when they remember.
We do, yeah.
And then they'll be playing, and hopefully the show will be very, very interesting. But like I said, you were here with me with your brother like a few
with
months
with
ago.
With my brother, yeah.
Where
my
brother is your brother?
Died. He's in Brazil right now.
Wow.
Yeah, he went back to Brazil for a while, and we're playing together.
Oh, for a while. What does this mean for a while?
Well, until the end of this year, or until
it's coming back.
He's coming back.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
He also plays guitar.
Yeah, he is an amazing guitar player, and he's the reason why I'm a singer. I mean, I've always wanted to be a singer. I've always known deep in my heart that that's what I wanted to do. But I didn't sing, which is really odd, you know? Like, I just had this in my mind. I'm going to be a singer. But then I wouldn't sing. And I would tell that to my parents. They'd be like, but you don't sing. How can you not want to be a singer? And then my brother started taking guitar lessons. And I was just like, maybe I should do the same with vocals. And then 2 years after he started taking guitar lessons, I started taking vocal lessons. And I was just really shy. I thought, no, this is not for me. But then, like, I would look myself in the mirror and I would, like, practice and my moves and everything. I was just like, this is what I want to do.
That's good. Awesome.
And then he moved here to LA about 3 years ago, a little more than 3 years. And then, like, almost a year later, I was like, you know what? I'm going to follow him and I'm going to go follow my dreams too. And I just came here. I had studied music, but nothing too crazy. I was just like taking private lessons. And when I moved here, my world turned upside down. Everything changed. I went to MI, which is a music school in Hollywood. And
that's where you both met?
Yeah, that's how we met. Yeah. And he was friends with my brother. That's how I met.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
How beautiful.
And then, yeah, I just started singing so much. I started writing songs. And then my life changed so much. I started playing live a lot. And then I just discovered this other side of myself, which I fell in love with. And I know for sure that this is what I want to do for the rest of my life.
Oh, that's great.
And, of course, we'll be listening to you live. You are a very passionate singer. Passionate. You sing beautifully. Your voice is very strong and perfect pitch. Then I don't even understand how in a short period of time you are so confident singer. It's not about being arrogant, but you are confident. You really sing your heart out. And your lyrics are beautiful. I'm almost scared why they are so dramatic. Is something really not nice happen in your life? Privately?
I'm a dramatic person. No, I don't know. I have a really beautiful life. I'm really blessed. I have amazing parents that raised me in a really beautiful way, and I'm really grateful for them.
Wow.
And I have three older brothers that are just amazing, and I have a wonderful life. My family is amazing, and I have great opportunities, but I just have a way.
You're just not saying that because you're on TV and you know you're going to watch it.
Hi, mommy.
Yes. Yeah. Like, yes,
my
yes.
mom doesn't even speak English. So,
oh, that's good. You can say hi
to mama and
mama.
And brothers, three of them. We'll take care of well about Thais. She's just a very special child, and you raise her very well.
Definitely.
Stays on the camera forever. Yes?
What was I saying? I know. I forget. I remember and I forget things. Yeah.
Don't worry.
That's okay.
I'm a Gemini. That's worth saying.
That's
I always blame it on my sign.
Gotcha.
We were talking about lyrics. We are talking about depth of your lyrics. They have a lot about relationships, which for your young age seems like who broke your heart so many times.
Well, I remember when I was younger. I actually told him that today. I told myself I would never write songs about love because I just hate them so much. I just think they're so...
So beautiful.
So common, you know, like, why would I want to write about that? But then it comes to me really easily. But I like writing about everything. I mean, everything. My parents, as I said, they raised me in a really amazing way. And they always read things to me and, like, these amazing writers and mystics and whatever. And I was just always very inspired by life, you know, things that happen, normal things, but I could look at them in a different way. And that really inspires me. But relationships... They happen.
They're gone.
And they're easy to write about. I mean, I try to be deep sometimes and write about life and the meaning of life and everything, but really
just I want to be sure that your
topic.
Heart is in one piece.
No, my heart is in one piece. Yes.
Thank you, God. Thank
good.
I know that
my heart has never been broken.
Yes.
Just my pride and my ego, I would say.
Oh, that's
which
worse.
Is fine.
That's great.
Pride and ego.
Yeah.
For ladies like but you and me and... Oh, no, not you.
I'm
you are lucky. You are happy. Okay, Raz. Hello, Raz again.
I'm doing great. How are you guys doing?
We are doing headache. 4th July. I didn't
think
you should
like
come back.
No, I know not anymore.
Okay.
It's kind of...
You're hiding it very
kicking.
Well.
Advil.
Yeah, yeah.
Advil. That's what you
kicking it, hopefully.
Don't
Advil.
Do it.
Yeah, yeah.
It's bad for you.
Yeah,
that's one of the things my parents have told me.
Really? Advil is bad for you?
No, don't take medicine.
Really?
That's terrible.
No, no. You have.
I grew up without medicine.
Really?
I only went to the doctor before I moved here.
You know, I will tell you a sad story about one.
You never had headache?
So, no.
Oh, actually, yeah. There was a period of my life, why am I even talking about this? But okay. There was a period,
so
now I have
to
say.
Now you
very
have to say, you started.
Yes.
There was a period of my life which I had headaches like every single day a year. Yeah. Wow. Every single day, the That's whole petrifying. Time.
That's crazy.
The whole time.
Yeah. You didn't go to doctor?
And I went to an alternative doctor. Okay. And how do you say iridologist? I don't know. He analyzes Look your iris.
I don't even know. Oh, okay.
Yeah. So at the time, I stopped eating meat when I was about 11, 12.
So and you're then vegetarian right now?
Yeah, I'm a vegetarian right now. But I think at that time I was a vegan, and I was about like 14, I think. And so I went there, and then he told me I had to start eating meat again. And I was like, no, and I was so stupid. So I was 14, so I was like, I don't want to eat meat, you know? And then that's what he told me. I started eating meat and again, like fish and chicken. And I actually got better.
You see, he was right. Iron. I always say meat is good.
But now I don't eat meat anymore.
When really? I have a headache, I always take Tylenol. Really? And we can do commercial for Tylenol.
That's right. That's
I
right.
love Tylenol.
I take Advil.
Advil? Okay. Advil. I'll be fighting. Who will be sponsoring our show? Coming back to Raz. Hello, right. Raz. How many years you are in LA?
I've been here about 4 years.
Wow.
Moved here about a couple of years after high school in Malaysia. I was in a music school in Malaysia when I was right after high school, when I was 18 or 19, if I can remember. And I was supposed to go to Berklee College of Music.
Okay.
I was like in a 6 months transfer program. But after a while, I did some research. I'm like, no, this is not rock and roll enough for me. You know, it's like I'm going to Boston and everything. And I realized that I'm a rocker, you know. And the only place that I've always go for vacation with my family has always been L.A.
Oh, okay.
My parents love L.A. so much.
Okay.
Yeah.
How far away is Malaysia from L.A.?
14 hours probably flight.
I would say 12 hours to Japan and 6 hours to Malaysia.
So like longer than to Poland.
So it's like it's longer to Poland.
Oh, Marechku, then
we're not going to Malaysia.
Yeah,
But I love flights. It's funny that a lot of people that I meet hate flights, hate flying.
Yeah.
But I just love flights.
I like to. Yeah. I sleep.
Probably because
in a second, I just go and they need to wake me up and give me food.
A lot of people hate hospitals. I love hospitals.
Oh, you go there often?
No, I went there 3 times pretty much for my operations, whatever was done.
Would you go there
Vacation
again?
Yeah, for you.
And I would love to go. You know why? Because everybody takes care of you.
Yeah.
Everybody.
You feel love.
Yeah, I feel love in my home and stuff like that. But you know, like, you don't have to do nothing.
It's so
just like,
you know? You just, you press the buzzer, you go, come here.
Be careful what you wish for.
I know. Right?
But a lot of people say, I hate hospitals, you know? And I say, it's not that. So that's what I'm saying. Different loves for everything.
Yeah.
You know?
And they give you good pills. You don't know that you're hurt.
You know, they're like, yes. Woo-hoo.
You don't get pills outside of hospitals?
No, I'll tell you. Inside hospitals, they give you stuff.
Yeah, right.
That will give you stuff.
You left, you said mommy and daddy like to visit LA and they like vacations here. Then you have a contact with your parents and family a lot?
Yeah, a lot. I mean, I'm the only child.
So you're like that.
We speak every day.
Oh, God, that's awesome.
And I'll feel awkward if I don't really speak to them every day. I might be an only child, but we do fight a lot as well.
Yeah, of course.
Brutally honest.
Yeah. Love is, fighting.
I'm sure they're a little scared because they're far away and you are alone doing your life your way. You have a passion.
It was. The first couple of years, it was hard for my mom especially.
Right. Oh
my
God. The only child leaves.
My dad was okay, do whatever
you want.
Son, go
for it. Yeah, don't go for it. Yeah.
If I may ask mommy and daddy what they're doing.
My mom do a lot of, she helps her sister's business in Malaysia.
Okay.
So she travels to Dubai. Her
independent woman.
Yeah, it's very independent. Wow. She was a stewardess.
Oh.
And my dad is a pilot.
Oh, that's so hot. Okay.
So that's
why you like flying. That's why you like flying. It's in your blood.
Yeah. And I was probably made in an aircraft.
Whoa.
You never know.
Mom, dad.
Mom
good job.
And daddy, great
Mile
job.
High Club.
Mile High Club. That's right. I am a natural born Mile
High Club. That's right. Yeah. Congratulations then.
And yes, your passion is to play guitar.
Yeah.
And I read your bio. It's very, very sweet.
Thank you.
You are very young. Then, but parents played to you a lot of rock bands, yes?
When I was, ever since I was a kid, I had a lot of musical connection history because my mom and dad would play like Eric Clapton, Led Zeppelin, Aerosmith, you know,
how about Scorpion?
Sometimes,
Oh, yeah,
sometimes.
Yeah,
right.
Mommy and daddy. Yeah. Your son met.
I was kind of late to the whole scorpion wall.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Yes.
But yeah, my dad especially would play a lot of rock music.
And they are not musicians.
They are not. My dad is a casual musician. He plays drum. So basically, I was introduced to music at a very young age. Very, very young age.
And they needed. They didn't need to push you to play.
They never pushed me. I never wanted to play music. The thing is that I was into sports.
Okay.
Oh. I've always been into sports activities. I like moving. So
okay.
I remember I was playing tennis a lot.
I was playing tennis a lot, and
my dad sent me to Malaysia's best tennis coach. Tennis coach every Saturday, Sunday morning. I would go and learn to play tennis. And after 6 months of playing with that coach, and I start realizing that I'm not getting any better.
You're not good with tennis.
And I start taking the tennis racket and start like playing the guitar. Just and then my coach would like scream at me. He's like, Russ, what the hell are you doing?
That looks good with me.
I was like, oh shit, I'm sorry.
And then
this one day, that coach told my dad that, hey, your son is doing something else in the tennis court. You know, like, he's not improving and stuff. I was like, and then I remember that moment when I got in the car. My dad said, hey, do you want to play guitar?
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, the first time. And I was like, I don't care.
Yeah.
I remember I said that to my dad.
Really? How old are you?
I don't care. I was like 9.
Oh, yeah. That's, yeah.
Yeah, I was like, I don't care. Whatever. Yeah. And we went to the guitar store. He bought me a classical guitar. And then I started playing classical. And it works very well. I started finding myself. Because I remember when I was a kid, I want to find something that reflects me.
Yeah.
That's
and
awesome, yeah.
Sports was never something that reflects me, something that people would remember me for.
Right.
And it slowly got connected to me that music is one
and
of
it's
them.
It's just beautiful what we are talking about, because I am also parent and I have two beautiful daughters.
Yeah, me
one,
too.
Yes, you have also two beautiful daughters. My both daughters are in the music business. One has a doctor degree and she writes books. It's all about classical music. She's in Brussels and has her very good. You can check on the Facebook. It's called Mea Cultura. Mea Cultura, one word. You can learn a lot about just culture and music and classical music, pop interviews. Really, really good website. But again, she writes beautiful books about great composers. I am very proud of her. I don't see her a lot because she's in Brussels. When it comes to my younger daughter, she just finished music business at USC. Then and she's like going to left and right, into film production, then you never know what child choose in life. But what is so important, if parents listen to us, that all of our guests, even Ralph said a moment ago that his parents introduced him to guitar and they were playing music. It's just so important. Music is very, very important. And I think in America, in funky way, it's like second will.
Right,
everybody
right.
thinks sport maybe, oh, it's
yeah,
hobby.
Yeah, sport is most popular
for
30, yeah.
6 months or 7 months, then something else, something. Just let the child to choose. In some moments you don't want to practice, you don't want to do this, but let it go. Let them just have from time to time contact with instrument, because eventually if this is real passion, the instrument come back to their lives with real, real importance, like to you, yes?
Yeah.
Because you decided to study and in Musician Institute, yes?
Yes.
It's
yes.
a very cool school.
Very. Definitely.
It's amazing.
Because of the location, too, as well.
Yeah, Hollywood, and you have all these
LA
hard people
and everything.
Like,
you know, it gets me connected.
And like you said, people who want to play pop, rock, jazz, and they just are the same age, and it's the group of very cool musicians together.
Yeah,
you were there,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, I went there as well, yeah. And the teachers are just amazing. They're really experienced musicians that play live. They're not just teachers, you know. They actually did that for a living, and they have so much to tell and so much to teach us about.
They have passion about it.
Yes,
like
yes.
Not the regular teachers.
So yeah, they're not just teachers, you know.
Right.
Like they actually went through that.
Okay.
So it's amazing how much we learn from them.
Some of
it's
my friends
awesome.
Were teaching there, and they were playing on my albums. Joey Bazou is very good. Yes.
That sounds familiar.
Yeah,
yeah
he
right?
was teaching for a few years, but right now he's so successful doing his own things. And one of my talents that I was developing, she finished singing, Christina Mota also. Then, you know, just, I know it's a good place for people who dream. I think time for music, whatever
right.
we say.
Most definitely.
as we are on camera. Now we can see our beautiful singer, which she sang amazingly on the radio. She will do the same here. It's tough because she cannot stand up. It's really tough to perform. But trust me, for Thais, she doesn't care. She sings because her heart wants it.
Awesome.
And let's just listen to the song. What song would you like to sing to us?
Okay, since you're saying that I only sing about relationships and stuff.
I
like it too. I'm going to sing a song that is very different from this side of me. And this is a song I wrote not too long ago, about some months ago. And I was writing, I love collabing with people and just writing with other people, because I just feel like it's two different minds thinking in the same head. I don't know. And it's just, you learn so much from the other person, and you just write about things that you wouldn't write before. Yeah,
for sure.
So I was writing a song in Portuguese with this friend of mine, and we were just talking about life and everything, and he's from Ecuador. And we started jamming, and I just started singing this melody, and this lyrics came up to me, and I said, what was it? I don't remember. But
she's Gemini.
I'm a Gemini. Right. but I was just singing this melody, and it was about immigrants.
Oh, okay. Oh,
wow. And we started talking about it, and...
So it's everybody of us.
Yeah, all of us.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, I remember now. So it was like that. If you're looking at me, why can't I look at you? If you call this place home, why can't I call it too? We're talking mostly...
Damn, woman.
Let's cry.
It's just like, yeah,
that's,
I know.
So sweet.
That's so true.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Those few words, it's amazing.
Yeah,
I mean,
repeat. That's a beautiful...
Yeah, yeah, just, yeah.
Well, if you want to play the chords, I can sing
yeah,
it to
yeah,
you.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay,
yes,
yeah.
Yes,
can
yes.
you just play... If you're looking at me, why can't I look at you? If you call this place home, why can't I call it too? Well, that's what I said.
Oh my gosh.
That's
so awesome. That's great.
Wow. Now I really need
that's
to
so
know
true
what's
too.
Happened in the
yeah.
song.
Because
you can
imagine all the immigrants who came here, they want to be like everybody else here.
So
and those
yeah.
simple words, what you just said, it's totally...
Yeah, I feel like we all feel like this.
Right, right.
We're talking mostly about illegal immigrants.
Right,
but
it's
at the
not
end
even
of the day,
because, you know, I was legal pretty much. You know, we had a political assignment. But what I'm saying is, when you listen to the words, it's literally, you want to be like one of those people in this country.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you came from somewhere else and you
outside,
go, wow,
you
I want to
be
like them.
Yeah.
That's what we hear.
And we
you
know that life in the beginning is pretty tough.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
It is.
You both knew English. That was good. I had a
for
issues
us, yeah,
with this till
yeah.
this day. I barely speak, you know. But this country is just beautiful and very welcoming.
Yeah, it is
beautiful.
And it's part of this beautiful earth, you know. And I feel, why do we need separation? It's all the same thing. And then we were talking about that. And then I went home. And a few days later, I was just like humming the melody again. And then I thought about the topic, and I just started watching documentaries about mostly Mexicans that cross the border illegally and come to the U.S., and how sad it is to leave their families there, or some of them come with their children, and then they get caught, and then they have to go back, and their children are living here without anyone.
That's just,
and it's just really, really sad. And I started crying so much. I remember this was one day that I just stayed at home. The whole day I didn't do anything. I didn't eat. I was just writing the song. And it talks about... I'm describing the journey of someone crossing the border and coming here, and just, well, I'll just sing it.
Yeah.
It's called Sons of the Universe.
Okay.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Ready?
Yes.
Just calm me in.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4. Ooh, fast, it's time to go back, all the stuff you own, leave the past behind, 'cause you won't be back in time. Walk, walk until you run. Don't stop until you've flown. But you gotta hide until you reach the other side. There's a better sun rising up. There's a better sun rising up on the other edge. At least that's what they said. 'Cause we are the sons of the universe. There's no line separating us. We breathe the same love. We are bigger than the storm. even stronger than before. We are one. Move along the dry field until your skin becomes your shield. Let the pain beneath your feet elevate you to your dreams. Walk, walk until you run. Don't stop until you flown, until you have crossed the finish line. There's a better sun rising up. There's a better sun rising up on the other edge. But it sets for us, 'cause we are the sons of the universe. There's no line separating us. We breathe the same love. We are bigger than this war and stronger than before. We are one.
Baby, you are beautiful.
I couldn't finish the song, but
I don't know, but this song is beautiful.
Again, I don't
your
know, it
voice
just got to me.
Is beautiful. It's wow. So nice to see a young lady
with so
like
much
you
soul.
With so much soul and caring about stuff that maybe we don't think on a daily basis.
No, we don't.
No, we don't. Again, well, the toughest things of
being. I'm sorry. I started
great.
Crying.
I know being immigrant is just really, really tough for you, miss your family.
Yeah,
you
I don't miss my family. And one thing I would like to share about, and I think this is the reason why I'm crying, is just that my brother, I used to play with him. And the reason why he's not here is because he's an immigrant.
Right,
and
right.
He cannot come back.
So it really hits me.
Oh, babies. I don't know. And what can we do? Please, Donald Trump, don't scream at people who want to come to this country, and mostly they work very hard. Mm-hmm. I think most of us have our own dreams, and we came here for many different reasons. But when we are here, we want to feel like in home, and we try to do the best.
Plus, the country is based on immigrants.
Yeah.
Plus the country
it's
is
based.
And
that
we
is
have
true.
And there's no, it is never in the Statue of Liberty says you have to be political assignment or anything else. Statue of Liberty welcomes everybody.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's the main
How
thing.
Sweet. And today we have two polls.
You know? Two
Marek Bacik,
that's right.
Ilona, you're from Poland. We have Thais. Your second name is very unusual. You can
Lajis, that's my last name.
Yes,
but I'm trying to distinguish that and just keep Thais.
Oh, Thais, right. I like it too. It's much easier.
Very simple.
But you are from Brazil, and
yeah.
Again, Raz is from Malaysia. We have a beautiful accent on and on TV. The 1 hour before, we had also
on the radio.
On the radio, German accent because Raz. Is a German
right.
And bass player for Scorpion. And we had also a French-accented gentleman, Christophe Petit, he has so many different businesses, very unusual gentleman. But please go to our Facebook pages and learn about these wonderful human beings, artists. We all are from somewhere else, but we are doing so many good things, I think, in this country, in our country, because your mama and dad and your people who you are visiting not long ago, you went to visit your homeland. Yes, they are proud of you. They probably
hopefully
cannot wait.
Come on, after a song like this, you have to be.
We are saying hi to everybody, and please, when you look at your friend in a store in line and look at them, mostly they have all different faces, different eyes. But
because we're from Poland, we really never were raised prejudice to anything. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, for us, black person was novelty. It wasn't racist. It was like, oh my God.
Yeah.
He's black. You know, so it was never back in Europe. There was never, you know, about, you know, what country you're from, which is kind of weird. When you come here and when you go back to 1950s, what USA did to people and it's like crazy how behind they were at these times. Yeah. I mean, you know, you get black people putting them in the back of the buses. I mean, that's just stupid.
Literally, insane.
How can you in 1950s Poland? We were not ahead of everything else, but we would never treat people like this. Never. I mean, that's just amazed me that this country was so ahead and it's so behind.
Yeah,
and erases.
It's a controversy.
That's
what.
Yeah.
Oh, so, but we are here. We have a beautiful two shows, accent on. We are talking about successful people and people who have a dreams that are living in America and doing very, very good for themselves. And that's the future of America.
That's
also the future of their own countries.
The young future.
Very talented, both of you. Raz, I would like to listen to you playing.
Yeah?
Yes, because mommy and daddy and all your friends, when we post this beautiful show,
because
they're
gonna
look
what
very,
Raz
very
doing?
Good. Yeah, they need to know that you really are playing well.
Your dad's got to know that when he bought you the guitar, it was a good investment.
Yes. Okay, just give it to us something.
Wow.
beautiful. You got us to different styles, little rugby, little blues.
I don't know what I was doing.
You were improvising. That's beautiful. Obvious. Your fingers are beautiful. Working very, very well. And
very well indeed.
So, Daddy, you get good investment.
Daddy, congratulations. Time for another song.
Another song.
Okay.
What do you want to play? I think we should play something a little happier.
A little bit happier.
I would love that.
Yeah, you put us in this mood and then, oh my God.
If you will be in your own room.
I couldn't even finish the song because I was crying. No, I want to laugh.
We'll miss your brother. He will be back. Hopefully everything will be okay. Okay, if you will be in your own country, in Brazil, if somebody will ask you to sing something for them or of something from your country, what you will be singing? Maybe that's out of...
I was writing a song in Portuguese. The
other day. Oh, there you go.
Yes.
Do you want to play it? It's really. No, I'm just going to sing a little bit.
Okay, of course.
Perfect.
What is it?
We don't need to just play. just tell me what chords there are there.
G's. Just play me a G7.
Okay.
And then D7. Play me a G major 7.
Okay.
Okay.
And then a D7. And then just keep alternating.
This is a live TV. It's the best
I know.
Of Holy. Live TV. Songs are not only sung live, but just backing that. Track is created right
can
now.
Play there you go. Maybe no. Play me a D major 7.
Okay, that's okay.
Yeah.
Now it's sounding more Brazil.
Okay, I'm gonna try to relearn the lyrics, but it's fine because you guys won't understand.
We will love it. We don't understand, but it would be great.
A bossa nova que não para de tocar. É gente nova que não para de chegar. Tanta gente vem pra cá buscando seu lugar. Tanta gente vem pra cá tentando se encontrar. F major 7.
I'm just making the song right now.
Mas olha, rapaz, G major 7. Olha, vem, olha, vem, olha, vem. Não se deixe esquecer. De onde vem, de onde vem. D major 7. O sol.
For sure, premiere.
That's awesome.
For sure, premiere. Thank you, Raz.
That's awesome.
Very good trooper. Thank you so much. And I know you're playing a little bit guitar. I see your pictures with instrument. And God, thank you.
Maybe she's only posing with the guitar.
Maybe.
You never
that's
know.
That's actually what I'm doing.
That's the main thing.
Okay. Oh my gosh. You know, we have 10 more minutes.
Okay.
Sing whatever you want right now.
Okay. Both so let's do a happy song. High
happy,
energy.
Happy, happy, happy.
Can I have some of your water? I like water.
Okay, of course.
Finish my. Okay, let's do Baba Baby.
Baba
so
Baby?
So this is a happiest song that you guys
can sing. What's Baba Baby means?
Okay, so Baba Baby, it's actually... Okay, I shouldn't say this.
Okay.
Baba...
Mama, don't listen.
Okay, so Baba in Portuguese means spit.
Spit? Really? Baba?
Yeah, like when you... How do you say the...
Drooling?
Drooling? Like you see somebody? Like
when you see someone and just like...
Oh, okay, you gotcha.
So we have the song in Portuguese, which is Baba really bad. Really bad, you know, like...
Gotcha.
Really bad pop song.
Uh-huh.
And it's called Baba Baby. So when I was writing this song, the chorus kind of goes like Baba Baby.
Uh-huh.
Blah, 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 blah. So I was like, this song sucks.
So you just changed
it. I don't like it. So I'm just going to make fun of myself and name it that stupid song that,
Baba.
That I used to like when I was 7 years old.
Oh, okay.
And then I just named it that. And I never thought I would play it for anyone. And then I showed it to my brother and he was like, this song sucks. And but then, like, we started playing with the band. And then when we started playing it live,
people
it was
like
just
it.
So awesome because people love it.
People just like,
and
yeah!
It's such a sing-along song. People just sing along to it. And it's just amazing to see everyone singing
like
it with
right.
me.
Don't question why people like certain
the
things.
The worst songs you write are the ones that people like the most.
Good.
Awesome. I'll never underestimate.
Gotcha.
Your work.
Accent on the best of Poland and Europe.
That's
and
right. Baba
Brazil
Baby.
And Malaysia.
That's right.
Is right now. And we have another premiere, probably. Live. Only in our studio.
It's Baba Baby.
Ready?
Yes.
Come here.
1, 2, 3, 4. I got all the answers that I've been looking for, and I'm looking forward to share them with you. I did not know what was going on until the day I woke up by your side. I didn't want to say a single word. I didn't want to think. I just wanted to smile. And you can take me for a ride. Ooh, we'll disappear for a while. Cause ba 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 be so much shy and funny at the same time. I love the way you don't give up till you get what you want.
Okay.
You make me feel like gold. You make me wanna be nothing else but me. And you can take me for a ride. Ooh, we'll disappear for a while. Cause ba 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 baby. I think I like you.
Hi, it's Rad.
Yeah, Ilona.
I understand why people need that. One more time.
Okay, so let's go back to it. I say ba 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 baby. Oh. I think I like you.
I know I do.
Ba 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 baby. I think I like you. I think I do. Ba 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 baby. I think I like you.
Ba 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 baby.
I think I like you. I know I do. Ba 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 baby. I know I like you.
She went dangerously.
I know, she did.
Great.
Wow, that was an awesome song.
Very good song, lovely song.
Thank you.
We always repeat, and hopefully this will be a truth, but Marek and I, we are trying to put a show together. They're the coolest of our coolestestes.
Right, coolestestes of the Accent On.
People from Accent On, our guests, they will be on the stage and everybody will have one or two songs, that's it. But we'll
that
go
is awesome.
Run through.
Yeah, they'll be there.
And it'll be that's so our, many
that's
accents.
Our dream.
I want to be part
that's
of it.
Yeah, I know, that's you, our dream. You will be, come on.
That's why you're here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Plus with your friend, you know, come on, you guys got to be there. But I think that the youngest guest.
Oh, gosh, don't say
from
it.
From the singers? I think they are.
I will have some youngest one, remember?
Oh, no,
under 12
let's say
years
the
old
youngest over
Kira.
18.
Yes. Anyway, one more time. If you would like to get in touch with you,
somebody,
I post
yeah.
your mm-hmm. Information on my okay. Accent On, but you maybe tell us how to find you.
It's just my website. It's easy. It's
closer to microphone, yes.
It's oops.
Yeah.
So it's razazraimusic.com. RAZ AZRAAIMusic.com. Same goes to Facebook. It's facebook.com/RazAzroyMusic. That's pretty much it. Maybe probably YouTube. YouTube has a lot of my stuff.
Oh, okay.
But it's a little bit different. Channel, it's yes. youtube.com/RUST92 because
just write it.
Just
your 92. Name.
I was trying to again, be cool, and I was like,
we always mess up these things. Yeah. But everybody can go on Accent on radio and Accent on TV, the best of Poland and Europe. I post all links and pictures of our artists when people want to find you.
Well, I'll be releasing my EP soon and the new material soon. So I'm changing all of my social medias. So it used to be Thais Lages, but now I'm changing it to Siat Music, which is my name backwards, and it's S-I-A-T. And you'll be able to find me at Instagram, Facebook, my website, at everything at this under this name, siatmusic.com. But for now, just look for Thais, T-A-I-S, L-A-G-E-S, Lages, which is my...
I'm sorry, it's not easy. The names are very crazy.
So that's why it's going to be only Thais, T-A-I-S, with the accent on the I. I like to...
That's even more complicated, but maybe after first hooky song that we heard, I really, really like you, then we will be knowing perfectly your name right away. But again... All the information is on Accent on Radio and Accent on TV, the best of Poland and Europe. Also, Mareczku, how is your headache?
It's better now. It's after the songs. It's like, I don't even feel headache. I was so into it.
I hope so.
That's a great song.
Marek Bacik, my co-host of this hour, Ilona Europa, host.
Host, that's right.
I'm so thankful for people watching and listening to our both shows.
And thank you so much for having us here.
The beautiful people will be back.
It's such a pleasure to be back.
Sure.
Thank you.
So much. You can push the button. Bye bye.
You're listening to Accent on TV, best of Poland and Europe, right here on LA Talk Radio.